People today are so self-centered. In the old days in Farasa, my homeland, people used to say, if you have some work that needs doing, don't leave it for tomorrow. If you have some good food, save it for tomorrow when a visitor might come. Nowadays people think, let's leave work for tomorrow when someone might come to help us, and let's eat the good food tonight. Today most people are self-centered. They think only of themselves. Let's say it starts raining very heavily. You'll see that most of you will start thinking of whether you have laundry hanging on the clothesline and will hurry out to pick it up. This is not a bad thing, but our thoughts do not go any further. Even if they get wet, the clothes will dry again. But what about those people threshing their harvest? Do you feel for them? Offer them a prayer? When lightning strikes, it is doubtful if a handful of people will think of the farmers or those who have greenhouses. People do not think of others. They don't go beyond themselves. Their thoughts constantly revolve around themselves. But when they revolve around themselves, they have themselves at the center, not Christ. They function outside the axis which is Christ. In order to be able to think of others, the mind must first be with Christ. Then one can also consider the neighbor, the animals, and all of nature. His radio station is working, and as soon as a message is received, he runs to help. If our mind is not on Christ, the heart is not working, and as such, we love neither Christ nor our fellow human beings. Not to mention the nature, the animals, the trees, the plants. By living this way, you will never reach the point of having communication with the animals, the birds. If a bird were to fall from the roof, you would feed it. But if it does not fall from the roof, you do not think about feeding it. When I look at the birds, I say to myself, the poor birds need to be fed, and I throw some crumbs, I leave out some water. I see diseased branches on the trees, and I immediately think of cutting them off, so the rest of the tree doesn't get infected. Even when a door or a window is banging, that's where my thought goes. I will forget myself if I should be needing something at that moment, and will tend to the door or the window, so that they will not be damaged. I might think of myself as an afterthought, and if someone thinks and cares about the other creatures, how much even more must he think and care about their creator? If man does not live like this, how will he ever communicate with God? Even when you simply go out, take a look around. Someone may have carelessly or maliciously, and I do not hope no one would do that, thrown something to cause a fire. So take a look around. This too is a spiritual act, for even a glance can bear love. And I come out of my kelvy, I take a look downwards and take a look up towards the roof to see if something is burning. Unless, of course, one has such faith that if something does catch fire, prayer alone will put out the fire. Otherwise, one must take action. Also, if I hear an explosion, I pay close attention to see what it is. Is it a gun? Are they practicing? Is it a blasting charge? My mind runs immediately to such concerns so that I may direct my prayer with a kombos koini. One who disregards himself out of love for others will have the great care of God, and all people will care for him. But today's generation is the generation of indifference. Most people are only for the parades. If something were to happen, don't even try telling them to defend themselves. And nowadays they don't like parades either. In the past, at least, people would go to the parades, listen to a marching tune, and something would stir inside them. Today, we Greeks are idle and lack discipline. Of course, other nations are even worse, without any ideals. You see, the Greeks may have a whole lot of faults and blemishes in their character, but they have one gift from God, Philotimo and Leventia, bravery. They celebrate everything. Other nations do not even have these words in their vocabulary.